Hello everyone, I am Prachivani. Welcome you all in this session. Today we are going to learn English spelling rules. In vocabulary building, it is very essential that as a learner of any language, we must use the words very carefully. Words always convey our ideas, thoughts, opinions, emotions, knowledge exactly and correctly if we are using that words very correctly. Hence, we have to pay little bit attention towards the spelling of the words. Sometimes we may misspell our words and because of that the error occur in writing. So, to avoid the spelling mistake, one needs to use your dictionary or spell checker if you are doing your any online activity. One can improve the spellings with the little effort, and almost 90% of English words can be spelled correctly if a student knows the basic patterns, principles or rules of spelling. Hence, today we are going to discuss for this English spelling rules. This course will be able to make you to use relevant words according to the context, and you will be able to remove the spelling errors in the given sentences or paragraphs. Also, you can speak more fluently in the formal or informal situation, and you can use correct pronunciation of such a words. So my question is here, why we have to learn the spellings? Because to learn the spelling is very critical component of communication. As far as English is concerned, we should be very much conscious about the rules of spellings. Even spelling and reading skills are closely connected to each other, and it will help to develop the literacy. If you want to become master in any subject, then it is essential to know the spelling of the words and know appropriate pronunciation of the words, because many of the times the spelling of any word is on the basis of how we pronounce the word. And if you are able to pronounce the words appropriately, then definitely it will lead to you to the literacy. Even spelling quality has its direct impact on employment opportunity. If we are going to think about more widely, then ultimately you have to become a very good writer as far as application letter is concerned. At the end of your education, you have to make the application for your job opportunity. Then if you are going to commit any single mistake in case of spelling, then it will spoil your image. So for that purpose, you must be very much careful about learning the spellings. So we are going to discuss about different rules of spelling. So rule number one. Rule number one tells us that consonant C says K, but it always softens to S when it is followed by E, I or Y. Now, the letters which have been written here into a slanting bar, it belongs to pronunciation. So, sometimes the consonant C is pronounced as a K sound, but sometimes it is softening to the S sound if any sentence, if any word in which the C is followed by E, I or Y, then it can be pronounced as a S. So example is given here, practice. So C is here bolded, it is highlighted. Because why S? Because it is followed by E. Intimacy, why C? Because it is followed by Y. Cylinder, why C? Because it is again followed by Y. City, YC, because it is followed by I. And C wheel, it is followed by again I. But this rule has an exception. C is pronounced as a K in the following words, like cake. It is pronounced, C is pronounced as a K sound. Cream, attack, logic. Why is it so? So this is the exception to this rule number one. Now rule number two. Consonant G may sometimes be pronounced as a sound of J as it is followed by E, I, Y. If G is followed by E, I, Y, then it is pronounced as a Z. Be careful. Gotch followed by E. Lodge followed by E. Ginger followed by E. Gymnastic followed by Y. Geographic followed by E. Biology followed by Y. Gesture followed by E. Many of the times we commit mistake whether I have to pronounce this word as a gesture or gesture, but mind this, it should be gesture because it is followed by E. Logic followed by I. Rule number 3, words ending in silent E drop the E before suffix beginning with the vowel. So if the word ending with E, then we have to drop this E if we have to do the addition of any suffix begins with vowel sound. So move, moving. So here in moving we have dropped E. In change, changing. Again we have dropped E. Instead of directly we have written here ing. Next rule, final E remains before a suffix beginning with the consonant. If we are going to attach a suffix which begins with consonant later, then E we have to leave as it is. So engage, engagement, E is there. Care, careful, E is there. But to this rule there is exception. If we are writing true, if we have to make the addition of suffix begins with consonant, that is ly, then we have to remove E. We have to drop E. So true, truly. Due, duly. Again addition of ly, removal of E. Argue, argument. Again here is removal of E because we are going to make addition of consonant. Ment. Whole, wholly. Again E is dropped, ly is attached. Nine, ninth. Again E is removed, just th is attached. Awful. Again we have to attach full, but we have to drop here E. The final E remains if the words ends in CE or GE to keep a soft sound with able or OUS. So courage, courageous. If we have to make addition of suffix OUS or able, then we have to follow, we have to use E, we have to carry it. Notice, noticeable. So we have to just attach A, B, L, E. We are not supposed to drop E. In case of noticeable, it is always happening the error. Manage, manageable. So again, you have to keep E as it is. In rule number 4, one syllable words ending in single vowel and single consonant double the consonant before as suffix beginning with the vowel. So beg, this is the single, or we can say one syllable with the vowel or single consonant. Yes, then in case of beg, if we have to attach here ed, that is suffix begins with a vowel, that is e, then we have to write down double letter of g, that is a last letter. Beg, baked. Hot, hottest, because we are going to make the addition of here suffix est, but it begins with vowel e. Run, running, like that ing, I belongs to vowel letter, hence last letter is here double. Sad, saddest, again est, e stands for vowel sound, hence last letter d is here double. To this rule again there is an exception, wish, wished. So here we are not supposed to write down double h. Yes, so this word is again here exception to this one. Fear, fearing. Again ing we are using, it again begins with vowel sound, the vowel letter I, but we are not supposed to write down here double r. So exceptions are always there. As you know that language is here arbitrary, we cannot ask this question why is it so, but rules are prepared. Rule number 5, if a word ends in double l, the second l is dropped when suffix full is added. For example, skill, skillful. So when any word ends with double L and if we have to make the addition of suffix F-U-L, then we have to skip one L and instead of that we have to use a full. Willful. So willful, single L. Words ending with I-E, change the I-E to Y when I-N-G is used, when I-N-G is added. For example, die, dying, I-E is dropped, instead of that y is used and ing is attached. Tie, tying, ty, ing. Lie, lying, ly, ing. So this is the rule number 5. Rule number 6, words ending in s, double s, z, ch, sh, x, ES form is added in plural. So when we have to use plural, when we have to make a plural of words ending with all these letters, then we have to use ES. Bus, buses. Business, again S, businesses. Watch, watches. Box, boxes. Quiz, quizzes. So in case of this quiz, we have to just double the last letter. So again, my answer is here, language is arbitrary. Next rule is here, words ending in F or FE changes to VES in plural form. For example, calf. This word ends with F, so it is changing into the VES. So the spelling will be calves. Knife, knives. Loaf, loaves. Here F is removed, FE is removed. Thief, again F we have to remove. So instead of that, thieves. Leaf, leaves. Wife, wives. Half, halves. Some words have both endings like VES or S also. Let us, we will see the words. Scarf, scarves. Scarves, also you can say in plural words, scarves or scarves. Dwarf, you can say dwarfs or dwarves. So these are the rules for making any word plural. Rule number 7, ly is added to the words ending in full, then we have double letters. For example, if any word ends with full and if we have to make an addition of ly, then we have to write down double letter. For example, careful, carefully. Faithful, faithfully. Grateful, gratefully. Beautiful, beautifully. Next rule, ly is added to the words ending in e. For example, love, lovely. Here we have to preserve e. We are not supposed to drop this e. Love, lovely. Live, lively. Like, likely. Complete, completely. So this is rule number 7. Now let us, we will turn to the rule number 8, where some of the letters are not pronounced or these are very silent or very negligible. So let us, we will see silent D. In case of this word, the pronunciation of this word, which is written into the slanting bar, it belongs to pronunciation. So how this word is pronounced? As a handkerchief. Yes, but in case of spelling, we have to use here D. Yes, handkerchief, actually handkerchief. But we are not using this D, D sound in pronunciation. So very casually we say handkerchief. Silent L. Here silent L. What is the pronunciation of second word? Kernel. Yes, but you cannot find here R in the spelling. So you are using here L. Kernel. So how it can be pronounced as a colonel? The spelling is here colonel, but it is pronounced as a kernel. Then silent P. What is the pronunciation of this word? Psychology. The pronunciation is given to the slanting bar. Psychology, that will give you hint. So psychology, it begins with P, but we never say psychology like that. No, so we are not supposed to pronounce like that. Sometimes absence of F letter, you can find out. The next word is pronounced as a lieutenant, but here there is no F letter, so the spelling is literally as a lieutenant. Yes, so here is the absence of F. Silent T. So in case of this word, the pronunciation is here tsunami, but there is no any T in pronunciation, but it begins with T-S-U-N-A-M-I. So tsunami. So it is a silent, or rather than we can say it is a negligible. So let us, we will see some of the words. You can have practice. Write correctly spelt word. This is a picture of what? The pronunciation is given, that is castle. So what is the spelling of castle? Pay attention, that is castle. C-A-S-T-L-E. Next one is here. What is the picture? It is of bouquet. And pronunciation is already given into a slanting bar. Bouquet. So what is the spelling of it? B-O-U-Q-U-E-T. Next one is here. Picture is of oats. How it is pronounced? Oats, but spelling is O-A-T-S. Next is here weird. How we pronounce it as a weird, but spelling is here W-E-I-R-D. Next is here embarrass. Embarrass, but the spelling is here EMBARRARSS. Though we are pronouncing it as a E, embarrass, but it begins with E. So you cannot start this word with the I. Next is your millennium. So spelling is here double L. MILLENNIUM. We will go further. Next is your calendar. Many of the times we are having confusion how to write down the appropriate spelling of calendar. So calendar begins with C and AR, DAR. Next is your definitely. Many of the times we pronounce these words as a definitely, N-A. But my dear, the spelling is N-I, definitely. So we should become your very conscious speaker of language. Next is your lollipop. So spelling is your L-O-L-L-I, lollipop. Next is parallel. So how the spelling? Parallel, double L-E-L. Across, the spelling is across. Last one is your interest. Cannot write down T-R-E, interest. Interest. Yes, go slow here. We will find correctly spelt word. Accommodate. So the appropriate spelling is here double M-O-D-A-T-E. A-double-C-O-double-M-O-D-A-T-E. Next is your acknowledgement. Acknowledgement always contain D-G. Yes? So, acknowledgement. Argument. Just earlierly we have seen this. Argument. Absence of E. Argument. Commitment. Double M. Yes, we have to use double M for the first and then M-E-N-T. Consensus. That is consensus. Consensus. Deductible. It is pronounced as a deductible, not deductable. Yes, very wrongly we are using that I have to go for deductible amount. So it is deductible. We will see next. Dependent. Dependent. D-A-N-T. Embarrass. Just we have seen this word. Embarrass. Yes. B-A-R-R-A-S-S. Existence. Existence. T-E-N-C-E. Not T-A-N-C-E. Next is your harash. Harash. H-A-R-A-S-S. Very casually we use this word, but we cannot write appropriate spelling of it. Then forward. Which forward? Yes, this is a forward. F-O-R-E-W-O-R-D. Forward. Lison. What is the spelling of lison? L-I-A-I-S-O-N. Lison. Do not go for incorrect word. So thank you very much. I hope you might have understood the rules of spelling and use it deliberately in your communication, in your writing. So thank you very much.